run around in it. Blossom on that. This diamond, my diamond. This rock, my rock. I woke up like this.
Welcome back to my channel. So I'm back with another easy coloring tutorial and an install video, so stay tuned. So today I'm using a 5x5 closure Burmese BODYWAVE pre-made wig from my collection, and I'm gonna take this 1B color and turn it into a spicy honey blonde that's perfect for women of color. You wanna make sure your hair is completely damp, so it's easy to run the product through. I'm using my go-to bleach, which is BW2. I'm using Third Developer and I'm pouring inside the bleach. Third Developer is like my favorite because it don't over process. It just process enough. You mix it all together. So you're gonna take the wig and you're just gonna put the bleach all over the hair. You want to get really deep inside the hair. You want to make sure all parts of the hair is covered. So just really go through the hair, put the bleach on, saturate it, work your hands through it. You want to use a brush and to brush through it to make sure it's an even transition so you don't get blotchiness. So just take your time and just open the hair and make sure you have get the bleach all throughout the hair. This is not a 1-2-3 process, but I promise you guys, if you take your time, you're gonna get our bomb blonde. So just take your time, make sure you definitely brush through the hair. Like, I cannot stress that enough. After you feel like you saturate the hair, you just leave it, and I left it about for like 35 to 40 minutes. So this is how the color came out. The hair is wet, so you're not gonna really see how it came out. But make sure you take a picture of this. This is exactly what we're using. And we're gonna use T35 and T11 because I'm gonna tone the blonde hair, because I like when blondes are toned. They just look more richer and more sexy. So we're gonna use the toner, and you're gonna pour one bottle of toner and then gonna pour two bottles of developer, and we're gonna do the same thing with T11. My camera died, so yeah, the video's about to cut off, so I can't show you how I toned it. But you're just gonna, when you mix it all together, you're just gonna put it all over the hair, and I left that on for about 25 minutes. I left the toner on for. Hey guys, so I'm back. My camera died, and I'm just gonna give up on this video, but I'm like, you know what? Although it died, I know you guys still want to see the end look and how the color came out. So, this is how the color came out from our 5x5 closure Burmese BODYWAVE pre-made wig. This is the honey blonde color. It came out. Like, it came out so lovely. And I definitely straightened it, like, so what I was doing before my camera died, I was showing you guys that I use the Wella toner in T35 and T11. So I use T35 and T11. And the reason I use both of these is because I like to see tones when I'm doing blondes. Like, I want to see different tones. Like, I want to see medium browns, blondes. Like, I don't like everything to be one tone. And if you see throughout my wig, I have different tones going on. So that's why I use two different toners, so you could get different tones of blonde. If you want one tone of blonde, you just use one color toner. So I styled it, I did a right side part, and I straightened her. And I'm gonna show you guys how she looks on. So we're gonna get right into it. So I'm gonna install this wig right now. My cap is on, my hair's in a little afro, it's growing back. I had did a big chop in December, but I'm gonna talk about that a little later, like probably in another video. So this is exactly how my wig is, and I'm putting my elastic band on. Like, all my wigs come with elastic bands, and inside of my construction is an adjustable cap. We have like the adjustable straps right here. My logo. So this is the inside construction of my wigs. So I'm about to put my elastic band on for extra security. Like, it's not needed, but I like to do it. I mean, it just makes me feel more secure. Like, I know some people, they just want to put their wig on and go. And although I'm a wig designer, I still like to make sure my wigs are super secure. So I'm putting my band on, and then I'm putting the adjustable straps so it can be extra secure. So we have the adjustable straps and you have the elastic band. Oh my gosh, why did I put this bodysuit on? Because now I can't do nothing with my hands. So my band is on, everything is on, and I'm about to just like flick it on my head. Hold on. She looks so good. Woo. Oh my gosh, she is fire. She is fire. Like, who is she? She is fire. No, so this is my wig, but honestly, girl, I'm trying to think. But the bowl is too tight, so I'm about to loosen it. So we're gonna take it right back off. And that's a good thing about the adjustable straps. Like, I like my wig secure, but I don't like a headache. I don't like headaches. I want it to be comfortable. So this is much better. Oh my god, I love this blonde. So this is what I mean, like, it's woman of color friendly. This is super woman of color friendly because it's not too loud. It's not a ratchet blonde. And what ratchet blondes is like when people would just, if you would just throw bleach on your hair and then wash it out and style it. Then you got that orangish blonde going on. Like, we like tone blondes. Like, you want a nice, sexy blonde. Like, you want that Beyonce blonde. You get what I'm saying? So, that's the type of blondes we want. We don't want, like, orangey ratchet blonde. No. Tone your blonde hair. You need to tone. Toning gives you the Beyonce blonde. So, now I'm about to cut my lace. Yeah, I'm about to cut my lace. And I kind of want to cut it here, but like, I don't have a little mirror in front of me and I really don't want to mess my lace. So I'm gonna cut my lace off camera and I'm gonna be right back. So I cut my lace off camera and you can definitely wear the wig like this. You just wanna put dab makeup. Just dab it. Don't OD. Don't OD. Don't OD. Like, you just dab. Like, hit it with dab, hit it. No, we don't woe. No, we don't dab no more, we woe. So just, you know how you woe that one time? But you're gonna do it like two times. And just dab. Don't OD. And you can definitely, so this is what you will call glueless, because absolutely no glue is on the wig right now. But I personally like my wigs to be glued down. It's nothing, I don't have nothing against people who like glueless, but I personally like at least one layer of glue on my wig. And it's, I just do that because that's like my personal preference. Although it looks good like this, I want it to be snatched and I want it to be on. And like people feel like you need 5-6 layers of glue. One layer of glue go a long way. And the glue I'm gonna use is, of course, Bold Hold. Can you see it, guys? But there it goes. Bold Hold Lace Glue. That's exactly what I'm going to do, use. So, I'm just gonna move my lace a tad back. Just like right here. And it kind of made a nice little dent for me. You see? So that's exactly where I'm gonna put the glue. And when I mean a little goes a long way, one layer for a closure goes a long way. And we're just gonna dab. And I'm looking in my mirror, but my mirror's like so far. So I don't wanna mess this up. And we're doing dots, guys. Boom. That much. Nothing else. Take your comb and just, and you're just putting a little dab so it could be sticky. But you don't have to OD. People feel like when you use glue, you gotta OD. That's it. Now I'm gonna take this bad boy. Oh, you see how it's sticking already? Oh. And I'm just gonna place it. I don't know how I'm working with these gloves on, but sis, I am doing it. Make sure, and when you're doing with the glue, you wanna make sure you place it. And just take the comb and push the lace in. Just want to push the lace in. Completely dissolve the lace into the glue. Yeah. Dissolve that lace, girl. You should get something like this. Real secure and on. I'm basically done though. This is basically my 5x5 closure Burmese BODYWAVE pre-made wig that I took from 1B and made it into this beautiful blonde color. Or I will have this exact wig on my website as well. And I think I'm gonna name her the Beehive. I'm not sure, but I would definitely, when I come up with a name, I would definitely link it below in the description box. But if you really feel like this video was very helpful, well, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And this is really the end look of everything.